It's Africa, right? Hey, I'm going now. Talking about the basics of mathematics also brings us back to the beginning of the 20th century, to the first year of the 20th century, 1901, with a mathematician named Bertrand Russell. Bertrand Russell has shattered the world of mathematics. He brought ideas which would very change the way we think about mathematics by introducing a paradox called Russell's paradox. It's a paradox about self-reference. Now his reasonings was made using set theory, so the idea of sets. But I'm going to be doing the reasonings with articles, so articles on the website, say Science for All. So on the website you can write articles, and in an article you can add links toward other articles. You can also add a link towards the article itself. Okay, so you had to write an article and you add a link towards itself. Such an article will say that it is self-referent; it refers to itself. Okay. So you can consider all self-referent articles, for instance. Now, what Russell wanted to do is to write an article that would refer to all non-self-referent articles. So he started to write his article, and then he wondered, should Russell's article be self-referent or not? Who thinks that it should be self-referent? Who thinks that it should not be self-referent? Who picked up on the fact that I said this was a paradox? Wow! Okay, so this was the paradox, because it cannot be self-referent and cannot not be self-referent. Let's see why. Assume it is self-referent, so it actually has a link towards itself. So if it is self-referent, then it refers to an article which is self-referent. Yet we only wanted non-self-referent articles here, so we get a contradiction. Now, on the opposite, if you assume that it is not self-referent, then it doesn't have a link towards itself, then it is non-self-referent, so it should be in the list, and we get a contradiction too. Now, this might seem like a very weird mathematical thing, but it's actually a very fundamental problem. It showed that in the core of mathematics, at least of the mathematics of that time, there was something wrong. There was something that showed, that proved, that mathematics was nonsense. Because here you have the construction of an object that cannot exist. And yet mathematics of that time allowed for the existence of an object that could not exist. And the consequences of that, well, is that you can prove anything. You can prove very easily from that 1 equals 0, or that 0 is different from 0. That's how bad things were back then. It seems that all the mathematics that was done before that was just nonsense. And it was a very dark time for mathematicians at that time. David Hilbert, another mathematician of the beginning of the 20th century, said that it was the priority of all mathematicians to show that we can have some mathematics which makes sense. And all along the beginning of the 20th century, mathematicians have struggled. They have worked and worked and worked to come up with a theory which would make sense, which would be consistent. So Bertrand Russell, in particular, Bertrand Russell worked with another mathematician named Whitehead, and they worked together on a new foundation of mathematics. It took them decades, so after 2 decades of work, imagine yourself working on this thing. It's very abstract, very theoretical, you have to be very careful. There were 3 or 4 books, I don't know, it's like thousands of pages of work. After a few thousand of pages, you get to the result 1 plus 1 equals 2. And after all of this work, you still don't have a proof of consistency of mathematics. That's how hard and tough things were back then. And they were desperately looking for this proof of consistency. And then came probably the smartest person of the 20th century. So here you have a physicist and a mathematician. So obviously when I'm talking about the smartest guy of the 20th century, I'm talking about the mathematician. Kurt Gödel. Well, what Gödel proved a lot of very disturbing results. And I'm just going to mention one of them here, is the fact that within any mathematical framework, which is interesting enough to contain the set of whole numbers and talk about its own consistency, basically any mathematics that we actually do, there was no proof of consistency. You cannot prove the consistency of the theory. This means that the mathematics we do today, we are forever doomed to hope that they are not nonsense. That's how bad things are. Okay, so let's light up the moon. This is going to be the last destination we will fly to. I want to go towards infinity.